थैंक यू प्रोफेसर पठाला फॉर द अपॉर्चुनिटी टू शेयर माय रिसर्च एट सच अ प्रेस्टिजियस प्लेटफॉर्म एंड गुड आफ्टरनून टू ऑल. आई एम थैंकफुल टू यू फॉर बीइंग हियर टू लिसन टू माय टॉक. वेल माय वर्क इज दैट आई एम गोइंग टू शेयर विद यू टुडे दैट इज अबाउट ए बी इनिशियो कैलकुलेशंस ऑफ ऑप्टिकल एंड स्पेक्ट्रोस्कोपिक प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ कार्बन नैनोमटेरियल्स. Before I start, let me introduce myself. I am an assistant professor of physics at Department of Higher Education, Haryana, in India. Currently, I am posted at Shaheed Udham Singh Government College there. Basically, Department of Higher Education, Government of Haryana, is an umbrella that comprises of 10 state universities, 24 private universities. There are around 70 government colleges, school government colleges of education, 86 self-financing degree colleges, 475 self-financing B.Ed. colleges, and 97 government-aided private colleges, all under the same umbrella. And our jobs are transferable. We can be transferred from one college to another. So right now, I'm posted at Shaheed Udham Singh Government College, Matak Majri in India. So let me introduce you with my work. My work basically is simulation work. In all the talks to be presented here, we saw that optics and photonics can have so many different dimensions in research. And the simulation is another dimension in this research in optics and photonics and spectroscopy. So experiment and theory have now a new partner, and that is simulation. In simulation work, the computational tools used can be categorized as shown here in this slide. There are two kind of computations, atomistic and quantum. And mine are atomistic calculations. And these can be on finite systems or periodic systems. And accordingly, there are different kind of methods. We can use quantum mechanical methods also. We can use classical methods also. I'm basically using quantum mechanical methods, and in quantum mechanical methodologies, there can be semi-empirical calculations and there can be ab initio calculations. So I've done all the ab initio calculations. And in ab initio calculations also, there are different hoops. Like they can be quantum Monte Carlo based, they can be DFT based, density functional theory. They can be based on Hartree-Fock method or molecular mechanics. Right, so in all my calculations, I have followed the density functional theory based methods. And that density functional based, theory based calculations, I have performed using the KESTEP code. And I have implemented that code using the software published by Material Studio, that is published by DS Biopia. This is a screenshot of the software calculations, the calculations being carried out by Material Studio software. So coming to my studies, one of my studies that I'm going to share here with you is phonon dispersion study on a single walled carbon nanotube. When I simulated the task on a single walled carbon nanotube, 90 single walled carbon nanotube I took. So the number of atoms in the carbon nanotubes, they are 36. And the codes, otherwise also, we can calculate that there should be 108 vibrational modes. And the corresponding vibrational phonon states domain, phonon density of states, you can see these are calculated by our software, Material Studio. And the study is published in Canadian Journal of Physics. So what I did, all the vibrational modes that were calculated using the software, I did the group theory analysis of those vibrational modes. So you can see the character table of the group theory analysis here. So main highlights are like simulated structure allows scope for 24 symmetry equations. And the group theory analysis revealed D6H point group symmetry of the structure, in which A and B modes, you can see here, there are different notations. These are standard notations. In these notations, A and B modes are non-degenerate, while E modes, they have a two-fold degeneration. Out of all these modes, the theory suggests that E1G, E2G, and A1G modes, these are known to be Raman active, while E1U and A2U modes, these are known to be IR active. So by calculating these modes, we can predict the IR spectra and Raman spectra of the structure simulated. These are the phonon dispersion curve. And in the phonon dispersion branches, you can see there are total 108 phonon dispersion branches, out of which we have allocated the modes to the branches. There are four acoustic modes, one longitudinal acoustic mode and two degenerate transverse acoustic modes and one twist mode. There are low frequency radial modes, as you can see as RM1 and RM2 here, and helical modes. And there are high frequency optical modes shown by the optical branches in the higher frequency region here in the this diagram. Now, out of all the modes, we segregated the modes which are Raman active. So, we differentiated E1G, E2G, and A1G modes. So, out of these modes which are Raman active, we can then simulate the Raman spectrum of the whatever structure we are simulating. So we had simulated the single walled carbon nanotube structure. So this is the simulated Raman spectrum, and on the right hand side you can see this is the actual experimental Raman spectrum of a single walled carbon nanotube. So you can see that the peaks predicted in the region 500 centimeter inverse to 1300 centimeter inverse. These are not observed in the experimental Raman spectra. So we suggested that it may either be attributed to the overestimation of their intensities or to the ignorance of some selection rule. Then I found some paper in which we can see these peaks between the region 500 centimeter inverse to 1300 centimeter inverse, these are actually observed if used if we use a sensitive spectrophotometer, and why bank at all, they have reported in a paper published in Spectrochemica at a part two. So you can see okay, there are certain peaks between this region that we have predicted theoretically. And the only thing is that the intensity of our predicted spectrum is slightly higher. These are very low intensity peaks actually. Now, same way, the way we segregated the modes which are Raman active, we segregated the modes which are IR active theoretically. And from these segregated modes, we simulated, we constructed the IR spectrum. So you can see, then we compared the spectrum simulated by us theoretically and the spectrum published in the Chemical Physics Letters by Yu Kohlmann et al. This is an experimental spectrum. So on right hand side, you can see this is an experimental spectrum of the same structure, and on left hand side, this is a theoretically calculated IR spectrum of the same structure. So you can see that the peak around 868 that is predicted in both theoretically, and it has been observed experimentally also. So we can see that our simulation is quite close to the experimental results. Now another study was molecular dynamic study of the vibrational modes. So all these vibrational modes which we are showing by the frequencies earlier, they were seen in molecular dynamical study also. The video I couldn't share with you. So you can see there are different kind of modes, like radial breathing mode, you can see the longitudinal modes, you can see the twisting modes, you can see. All these modes correspond to different peaks in the IR and Raman spectrum. Then another study I did using the same software and using the simulation calculations based on density functional theory was effect of co-doping on the optical properties of single walled carbon nanotubes. So these results were published in the International Journal of Light and Electron Optics, OPTIC. And this is again a 90 single walled carbon nanotube simulated by me. Then I used the pristine structure, did the calculations on its optical properties. Then I doped with co-dope, in fact, it is co-doping, not single atom doping. I doped two and three atoms. One of the structures you can see there, I have doped there, that is doped with aluminium and phosphorus. Two atoms are replaced, and in one of the structures, three of the atoms of the structures have been replaced by aluminium, nitrogen, and phosphorus, respectively. So, co-doping I picked up because doping studies were already there in the literature, they had been studied earlier. So, I picked up co-doping. And you see, in the simulation, we have to specify a different tolerance criteria for the system convergence. So these are the tolerance criteria for the system convergence that I use for these simulations. Now you can see these are the properties calculated. These are the dielectric function spectra of a pristine single walled carbon nanotube. Then an aluminium phosphorus co-doped single walled carbon nanotube and an aluminium nitrogen phosphorus co-doped single walled carbon nanotube. So you can see that the static values of dielectric function that we can derive from these spectra for pristine single walled carbon nanotube at that is 5.4, and for aluminium phosphorus co-dope and aluminium nitrogen phosphorus co-dope, you can see this value of dielectric function is reduced quite a lot. Same way, I simulated the refractive index spectra for all these structures. And from the reflective index spectra simulated for a pristine single walled carbon nanotube and the code of the single walled carbon nanotubes, you can see the changes in the refractive index. I have tabulated here the static values of the refractive index, so that can be drawn from this these spectra. Same way, I have simulated the reflection spectra. Reflectivity is plotted here with respect to the frequency. And these spectra suggest that reflectivity is reduced when we co-dope a pristine structure with aluminium and phosphorus. Though it the decrease is slightly increased when we dope another atom of nitrogen into the same structure. Then conductivity, this is optical conductivity. Optical conductivity also changes when we co-dope the structure by aluminium and phosphorus and another atom of nitrogen. You can see the variation here. The variation is quite visible. And then the Lowe's function I simulated. And this study has been published in Physica E, the low dimensional systems and nanostructures. So you can see There are substantial changes in the value of Lowe's function when we co-dope the pristine single walled carbon nanotube with aluminium phosphorus and aluminium phosphorus and another atom of nitrogen is doped. So from all these spectra simulated, what we can observe that as we change the structure, as we co-dope the pristine structure with some alien elements, we can get a control over the particular optical properties, and we can manipulate these variations to tailor the properties of optical materials to make them suitable for applications in designing various optical devices. That is the main motto here, to see how the various properties will vary if we do the doping or co-doping using some additional elements into the structure. Then there is another study that I would like to share with you, and that study is effect of conjugation on the vibrational modes. Basically, I found a paper in which it was reported that recently a single walled carbon nanotube dimer has been discovered, in which two single walled carbon nanotubes are just held by van der Waals forces, and they are parallel and they are forming a dimer, a heterogeneous dimer. So motivated by that paper, that was an experimental paper, motivated by that paper, I simulated a dimer comprising of a 50 CNT and a 60 CNT to study if in such a dimer, how the conjugation alters the vibrational modes of the structure. This study I did using the software package Quantum Espresso, and I used the periodic supercell approach to minimize the finite edge effects. The exchange correlation functional used in the study was local density approximation. In all earlier studies, the exchange correlation function used was GGA, gradient approximation. So then you see in theoretical calculation, we always have to use certain pseudo potentials that approximate the effect of the core electrons. So I use the non-conserving pseudo potential here in reciprocal space to reach the effect of the four electrons. Plane wave basis set with finite basis set correlation was used to expand the wave functions of electrons, and the lattice vectors were optimized in the plane as well as the atomic positions. Dispersion correction was also applied. That is very important because we have to take into account the intermolecular interactions, that is van der Waals interactions. Brillouin zone integration was performed using the Monkhorst PEX scale. So these are the vibrational density of states. You can see in this blue lines, they represent the vibrational density of states for the conjugated mode. Then both the CNTs are present for the dimer. The green is for 50 CNT, pristine 50 CNT. Pink is for 60 CNT, pristine 60, and blue is for the conjugated dimer. So you can see how the various vibrational modes change. The various changes in G and G dash modes, you can see. So if we take the modes frequency wise, so redundant modes, you can see there are negative modes present. They will vanish with non-zero value of U as force constants vary with the value of U. Single walled carbon nanotubes, they have a long interaction period. So if force constants with the distant atoms are not considered, they may generate fake soft modes. That is the reason for these redundant modes appearing here. Then in the low frequency modes, the well-expected RBN peaks with double splitting can be seen in the spectra of the individual CNTs between 250 to 300 centimeter inverse. But in case of single walled carbon nanotube dimer, you can see the atomic deformation potential vectors of both the single walled carbon nanotubes combine, and they result into splitting of the energy levels corresponding to the coupled vibrations of the two tubular structures following a quantized region. That is the reason because of which a number of additional peaks with spikes are seen in this low frequency region, you can see. Then in the intermediate frequency range, along with the well-known CNT spectra, there are these peaks observed that I predicted in the pristine single walled carbon nanotube structure also. These are termed as intermediate frequency mode peaks. So the peak in 400 to 500 centimeter inverse range that is assigned to double resonance and is believed to originate from an acoustic-like optical branch in single walled carbon nanotubes. As a result of conjugation, most of these IFM peaks reveal splitting, which reflects coupling between the vibrational modes of the individual single walled carbon nanotubes. Though we have used certain approximations because of which the intensities are slightly exaggerated here. In high frequency modes, G band normally appears as a single mode. But you can see the splitting of energy levels due to interaction energy of the coupled vibrations has resulted into a three peak structure in case of this asymmetric dynamo spectrum. So these are some of the studies that I had to share with you. And in this work, these are my collaborators, in collaboration of which I have been working. Madam Swastika Banerjee from Berkeley Lab, Lawrence Berkeley National Laboratory, US. Professor Swapan K. Pati from Jawaharlal Nehru Center for Advanced Scientific Research, Bangalore in India. And Professor Neena Jaggi at National Institute of Technology, Kukshetra. So alone we can do so little, together we can do so much. And there's a long way to go. This work has to be extended. I need your best wishes, and I would like to terminate here with welcoming you for the questions.